Hi, my name is Allie. I'm a respiratory care senior at Hudson Valley. I'm going to show you guys today how to do some LVN bleeds. So I'm going to start with my air to oxygen ratio. On my LVNs, I have a 35% LVN, and I want a 30%. So in order to find my air to oxygen ratios, I'm going to do the formula 100 minus FiO2 divided by FiO2 minus 21. So to find 35%, I do 100 minus 35 divided by 35 minus 21, which gives me 65 divided by 14. 65 divided by 14 is 5 to 1. So for 35%, I got an air to oxygen ratio of 5 to 1. 30%, you do the exact same thing, 100 minus 30 divided by 30 minus 21, which is going to give me 70 divided by 9, which is going to give me a ratio of 8 to 1. So I have an air to oxygen ratio for 30% of 8 to 1. I'm now going to show you how to get your total parts for your equation. You're going to need your total parts in order to find out how much oxygen to bleed into the system. So for total parts, you're going to add your air and your oxygen ratio together. So you're going to add 5 plus 1, which equals 6. So your total parts for 35% is 6. Moving on to the 30%, you do the exact same thing. You add your air and your oxygen ratio together, so your total parts for 30% is 9. After finding my total parts, I'm now going to figure out how much oxygen to bleed into the system. So I chose to put my 35%, which I have, on 12 liters. I chose 12 liters because you need a total flow of at least 60 liters per minute, or you need at least 3 times the patient's minute ventilation. Because I don't have a patient's minute ventilation, I'm going with 60. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the 12 liters that I have, 35%, I'm doing another air oxygen. So my 12 liters times my total parts, which is 6, is 72 over X, because I'm putting my 35% on air and I'm trying to find how much oxygen to bleed into the system, is going to equal the ratio of what I want. My ratio is 30, I need 30%, so what I want is an 8 to 1 ratio, air over oxygen. If I cross multiply, I get 8X equals 72, X equals 9. So my X equals 9, it's under the oxygen part, so it's how much oxygen I want to bleed into the system. Now I'm going to show you how to find your total flow to make sure that you're meeting your patient demand. So, total flow equals total parts times liter flow. So we found out that the 12-liter LVN on air is 35%, so total flow equals total parts, 35%, total parts we figured out was 6, so 6 times 12 liters, which is what the 35% is on, equals 72. So our 72 is our total flow, liters per minute, for our 12-liter LVN on air. For our 9-liter O2 bleed, we again do the same equation, total flow equals total parts times liter flow. Our total parts for 30% we figured out was 9. So 9 times our liter flow, which we picked was 9. 9 times 9 is 81 for our total flow. Now to make sure that it meets patient demand, you take the total flow of the 12 liters, which was 72. You take the total flow of the 30%, which was 81. You add those together. 153 liters per minute is our total flow to the patient, which more than exceeds 60 liters per minute. So therefore, our equations are correct. All right, so what I'm going to show you guys now is how to analyze your LVN. You're going to take the analyzer and you're going to try and calibrate it. You're going to do 2-point calibrations. You're going to do 100% and you're going to do 21%. In order to do 100%, you put a Christmas tree on the flow meter. You attach a glove to it. You put it to flush in order to get 100%. and you put this in here, and you wait for it to get to 100%. Once you get 100%, you're going to put it up just to the air and get it back down to 21%, and that would be a two-point calibration. So next I'm going to show you guys how to set up the LVN bleed. I grabbed an LVN that has 35% on it. I'm going to add my sterile water. I'm going to fill it up to the max fill line up on the top. I'm going to date and initial the sterile water. And then taking my LVN on 35%, putting it on air. And then going to take an O2 bleed adapter, which looks like this. Attach it to one end. Going to grab my oxygen tubing and with a Christmas tree, set it here, and then right on this little port right here.